Okay, well, so we did the Hartsville, Mrs. Rumsfield House last night. We found some very interesting things there. We didn't find anything in the attic. We didn't find anything underneath the staircase that could be considered substantial evidence. We did find it quite unique, all of her gemstones that she has found from around the world, especially from her last visit in Papua New Guinea and Australia. There was this moment where Steve was up in the attic. I was down in the bathroom doing a little half bath investigation in there. And I go towards the window, and I don't know. I see some figure outside that spooked the shit out of me, and I immediately run outside to investigate. The EMF wasn't picking up anything. I didn't see anything with my own eyes by the time I got out there. I radioed Steve to get down there as soon as he could. We get outside again. We don't see anything out there. We don't get any readings. We don't hear any sounds.
We didn't find anything outside. I mean, we scoured the whole property. We didn't go into the woods at all. But we looked around, and there just wasn't any signs of anybody being back there. And what's really baffling about it is how fast this person or thing moved.
Ran outside, checked it out. Of course, I was disappointed that I couldn't find it anywhere in sight.
I mean, Ryan had maybe 20 feet from the bathroom to get outside, and he bolted. And when you get out there, I don't think we've shown any footage of that, but when you get out there, it's just all open, and then it's the woods. They just have to move so fast. That's what's so baffling about it.
I'm thrilled that we caught something like that, but then again, I'm annoyed that we couldn't follow up with it.
It was disheartening for both of us, especially him, because he got to witness it. And I was a little disappointed I didn't. You know, I later got to see it on the video in the mirror. But, you know, it was disheartening that we couldn't take it past that. We couldn't find any proof outside. No footprints, no nothing. It's like nothing was even there. And so it's a little disappointing, but at the same time, it makes going into those woods more enticing, and we are really looking forward to that.
Now, because this is part one of a three-part investigation, we can't say that was anything. We can't say it was a creature from the woods. We can't say it was anything paranormal. Until we get a little more validity from the other two investigations, the other house and the woods themselves. It could have been something from the woods.
It could have just been a peeper.
Exactly.
A neighborhood peeper just going from house to house out there.
Ryan's Tahoe was sitting out front. That's got Monster Vision TV all over it. It could have just been somebody curious. You know, I'm sure Margaret had said something to her neighbors that, hey, these guys are going to be there. So it may have just been, but he moved really fast, if that was the case. So we're going to leave it like this for now until we get to the other house and the woods themselves. Didn't find anything in the attic like Ryan was saying, nor underneath the stairs. There was some interesting EMF reads and the light bulb situation and all that, but that's nothing that we'll sit here and say is paranormal.
All I can say is that this is a sign of things to come, that we are looking towards a great investigation at the woods of Prestwood Lake.